Hello everyone, today we are discussing the topic 3 of our unit 5, that is ADC, analog to digital converter. So up to now we are discussing about the digital to analog converters. Those are two types, weighted resistor and R2R ladder type. Again, inverted R2R ladder type. So today we are going to discuss the ADC. So before that, the struggle you are in today is developing the strength you need for tomorrow. So with this positive saying, I will start my lecture. So in today's class, we are studying about what is ADC, what is analog to digital converter, and why ADC is needed, why we need the analog to digital converter, and what are the applications of analog to digital converter, and how the analog signal will be converted to the digital signal, that is A2D conversion process. So first topic is what is ADC. So ADC is nothing but an electronic integrated circuit which transforms a signal from analog to digital. So the circuit which converts or which transforms the analog continuous signal into the digital, that is discrete signal, is called as the ADC. So analog signals are nothing but the directly measurable quantities, and digital signals are having only two states. For example, the digital computer, we refer only two binary states, that is 0 and 1. Analog signals are the signals, those are nothing but the real world signals, example pressure, temperature, and so on. So why ADC is needed? So today's world is nothing but the digital world. We can perform any task on the digital signals only. So the digital systems require only the digital signals require the digital systems require microprocessors, microcontrollers, and so on. The microprocessors can only perform complex processing by using the digitized signals. So that's the reason we are converting the analog signals into the digital signal. And already in the first class also we are discussing one thing, that is analog signal storage and processing is quite difficult when compared to the digital signals. So the digital signals can be stored easily and processing of digital signals is also easy. And analog signals are having more noise when compared to the digital signals. So the ADC provides a link between the analog world of transducers and the digital world of signal processing and data handling. So what are the applications of ADC? So first we are seeing what is ADC and why we need ADC and applications of ADC. So ADCs are virtually everywhere where an analog signal has to be processed, stored, or transmuted in digital form. So ADCs are used everywhere where the analog signals has to be processed, stored, or transported in digital form. Some examples of ADC are nothing but the digital voltmeters, our mobile phone, thermocouples, and digital oscilloscope. So already I am saying that microprocessors and microcontrollers are used ADC. So the ADC may be 3-bit ADC, 8-bit ADC, 10-bit ADC, 12-bit ADC, and 16-bit ADC. Mostly microcontrollers uses 8-bit or 10-bit ADC. So next is ADC process. So how the analog signal is converted to the digital signal? So in order to convert analog signal into the digital signal, we need the sample and hold circuit and quantizing and encoding circuit. So in the second chapter, we are studying sample and hold circuit. So whatever the analog signal coming from the real world is applied at the input of the sample and hold circuit. And here we are controlling this switch by the usage of this pulse. And the capacitor is stores the charging. The capacitor is used for the charging and discharging purpose. So here, once the signal is applied here, that is positive signal, the logic 1 is applied here. In that case, the switch is closed. And whatever the signal, analog signal coming from the input, that will be charged, that will be passed through the circuit, and the capacitor starts charging. And after some time, the logic 0 is applied. The switch is in open position. So the capacitor cannot discharge immediately. The capacitor holds the previous value up to some time. the capacitor holds the previous value up to some time, and again whenever the second pulse is applied, the switch is in closed position, so the capacitor charges to the input signal and it will charges up to some extent. And whenever the zero signal is applied, the switch is in off condition. The switch is in off condition in the sense the capacitor cannot discharge immediately. The capacitor holds the value up to some time. So in this way, the sample and hold circuit will convert the analog signal into some form of discrete signal, and this signal will be passed to the quantizing and encoding circuit. So at the output we are getting the digital signal. So the sample and hold circuit will convert the analog signal is continuous in time and continuous with respect to amplitude also. But the sample and hold circuit will convert the continuous in time signal into the discrete in time. So after that, this signal is processed to the quantization and encoding circuit. The quantizing circuit will convert this discrete in time signal into the digital signal. That means the sample and hold circuit will convert the continuous in time signal into the discrete in time, and the quantizing circuit will digitize this signal in amplitude domain. The sampling circuit will digitize this signal in time domain. The quantizing circuit will digitize this signal in amplitude domain. So finally, we are getting the digital signal. So we go through the sample and hold circuit. This is the continuous signal we are applied at the input, and this is the control signal at the switch. And this is the final sampled signal. This is discrete in time domain. And what is resolution? So resolution is nothing but whenever we are changing the analog input voltage, according to that we have to get the change in the digital input. So whenever we are changing the analog input, according to that we need to get the change in the current digital output. So the smallest resolution represents the smallest change in the analog signal that will result in a change in the digital output. The smallest change in the analog input that will result in a change in the digital output. So the resolution will be represented by delta V, that is the resolution, equal to VR by 2 power N. Here VR is the reference voltage. So whenever we are doing the problems or whenever we are studying the ADC circuit, we get to know that is what is VR. And 2 power N, here N indicates the number of bits. So for 3-bit ADC, N equal to 3. For 4-bit ADC, N equal to 4. For 5-bit ADC, N equal to 5. So here V is the reference voltage, V is nothing but VR, and N is the number of bits, and 2 power N is the number of states, and delta V is the resolution. The resolution indicates the smallest change in the analog signal that will result in a change in the digital output. Next is quantizing and encoding. What is quantizing? So quantizing is nothing but whenever we are digitizing the analog signal in amplitude domain. So sampling will done the digitization of analog signal in time domain, and quantization will done the digitization of signal in amplitude domain. So encoding is nothing but by using this table we need to understand the encoding. For example, if the analog voltage is ranging from 0.5 to 7.5, if the analog voltage is ranging from 0.5 to 7.5, and what is the corresponding digital output we are getting at the output. So if the voltage is 0.5, then it will be represented that it will be encoded with the digital data 001. If the analog voltage is 1.5, then it will be encoded with the digital data, that is 001. So 0.5 is represented with the 001, again 1.5 is also represented with the 001. So here we are having some error. So we are representing 0.5 with the 001, and again 1.5 is also with the 001. That means here in order to get the 1, we need to add 0.5 to this one. In order to get 1, we need to subtract 0.5 from this one. So here we are having the error is 0.5 volts, plus or minus 0.5 volts. This error is called as the quantization error. So after getting the analog output voltage, we need to encode that voltage with the some digital output. So that digital encoding of digital output will be like this. 0.5 is also represented with 001, 1.5 is also represented with 001, and again 1.5 to 2.5 we are representing this signal with the 010. So in order to get 010 represents the 2 volts. That is 1.5 is added with the 0.5, then you will get 010. 2.5 is reduced by 0.5, then only you will get the 010. So the accuracy of the A to D conversion will be improved by increasing the resolution or by increasing the sampling rate. So in ADC also you are studying about the sampling rate, Nyquist rate and all those terms. So the accuracy will be increased by increasing the resolution or by increasing the sampling rate. So if the accuracy is less, then most of the analog signal is not converted into the digital form. If the accuracy is more, the signal will be like this. So the analog to digital converters are mainly four types: dual slope A to D converter, successive approximation A to D converter, flash type A to D converter, and delta sigma A to D converter. And we are also having another A to D converters. Those are voltage to frequency, staircase ramp, or single slope, or charge balancing, or redistribution, switched capacitor, tracking, and synchro or resolver. So in the coming lectures we are going to discuss one by one, that is dual slope, successive approximation, flash type, and delta sigma. So thank you all. Today we are discussing about what is ADC, why we need ADC, and what are the applications of ADC, and what is the process that involves in analog to digital conversion. So thank you for watching the video. If you have any doubts, just ping me in the comment section. Thank you all.